Now Guerrero to challenge Chris Jericho for the European title. And this one should be a real classic offensive matchup between two great athletes. Oh, the drop toe hold. And referee Tim White took a header. Now Guerrero is in a bad, bad way. No referee in sight. Referee Tim White knocked out of the ring. She's not a referee.
Right. That didn't count.
What the hell?
DDT.
What the hell? China just DDT Chris Jericho. Look at China, the ninth one in the world, manhandling the referee. We have a new European champion. It's Eddie Guerrero. And thanks to China. But why did China stick the knife in the back of Y2J?
It's sinking in now. Latino heat. Latino heat.
I really couldn't resist your Latino heat. Poor little Chris always intimidated that a woman would show him up, steal his glory.
And another moment,
Jericho!
Arriba!
And Jericho clocks China! Underlay! Jericho, he wants revenge in a bad way! It's far from over between Jericho and Guerrero and China!
WrestleMania, and look how much the face of the WWF has changed.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Lita from Guadalajara, Mexico, weighing in at 217 pounds, Essa.
Essa Rios with the lovely Lita kick off a great hour of action. Later on, we will see Y2J Chris Jericho looking to rebuild after what had to have been a tragic week. The triumph at WrestleMania and the loss the following night to Eddie Guerrero.
From Japan, weighing in at 201 pounds, Funaki.
Essa Rios will do battle with Funaki Michael, a former hardcore champion, thanks to that hardcore battle royal at WrestleMania.
An unbelievable match. I thoroughly enjoyed it, as I did every match at WrestleMania. WrestleMania far exceeded its expectations. But talking about Jericho, I wonder what was the biggest tragedy. Was it the fact that he lost the European title? Or that China said that he was a little short when it comes to certain things?
And also the loss of the European championship, I know, is not going to sit too well with Y2J. So Jericho will do battle with Viscera a little bit later on in what promises to be a very entertaining hour. We've also got to talk about the McMahon family situation. The most dysfunctional family on television, Michael, no longer. All unified now and rallying around the prodigal son, I guess you could say, Triple H, the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Well, that's true. As Essa Rios lights into Funaki, I guess Vince McMahon felt he had to do what he had to do for his family. Vince, we've always known his passion for his family, especially Stephanie.
Essa Rios starting off very aggressively here this week against Funaki. We know Essa, a tremendous high flyer, artistic even, with the lovely lead at ringside, usually mimicking Essa's best high flying move.
Oh!
But Funaki answers with one of his own and sends Essa to the floor.
Hey, baby.
Little concern on the face of Lita, former light heavyweight champion Essa Rios. Ooh, very aggressive maneuver there, a drop kick to the knee.
Speaking of Essa being the former light heavyweight champion, I've got to wonder, when will Essa get his rematch with the current champion, Dean Malenko?
Dean Malenko very impressive with a win Thursday on SmackDown over former champion Takemichi Noku. Great block there.
Oh!
Nobody home. And Michael, of course, as we are 7 days removed from WrestleMania and the fact that Mr. McMahon, in effect, cost The Rock the World Wrestling Federation Championship. We'll take a look at that later on. Wait a second. Snap suplex covered. two, almost had him.
So close.
We've also got to think about what's next for the McMahon family, as they seem hell-bent and determined on driving The Rock from the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, you might say that The Rock this past Thursday on SmackDown laid the smack down on Mr. McMahon. And we know tomorrow night, wow, what a DDT. Raw will emanate from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And I'm sure The Rock is looking forward to Raw tomorrow night in Fort Lauderdale, but don't think for a second that the McMahons, Triple H, and all of DX don't have a plan for The Rock, and it won't be a good one.
We'll follow, of course, the Rock situation through the hour as we head to Raw tomorrow night. Funaki is step slow in the corner, and once again, Essa able to generate some offense out of a defensive situation. Listen to these chops.
Oh, yes!
Throughout this arena, but Funaki taking a counter maneuver and countered by Essa himself.
Uh-oh.
All Main is in the ring.
What does she do that to me?
Tremendous maneuver, not just by Essa. Cover two, almost had it, but by Lita as well. Let's take another look.
Boy, she sure has a lot of athleticism, Kevin.
We'll take a special look at the hardcore champion, Michael, as well. Crash Holly back on top of the hardcore game and still putting the title on the line 24-7. Crash is also going to be here in the hour defending that hardcore title against Sexual Chocolate and Mark Henry.
That should be a hell of a matchup.
Off the belly-to-back suplex, Funaki does not cover the leg, and I wonder if that impacted Essa's ability to kick out.
Not only did Funaki not cover the leg, he did not put enough body weight on the top of Essa's body.
Boy, last Monday on Raw, the vehement words of Mr. McMahon, not only, oh, look at this now.
Uh-huh.
Version of a pile driver there from Funaki. It didn't look good. It was very effective, very close to the ropes, and Essa able to kick out. Mr. McMahon with some vehement language towards not just The Rock, but also the L.A. community. And I know as Raw went off the air Monday night, things did not look good for the McMahon family. It was Triple H flat on his back, and The Rock hoisting high the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
Well, but Triple H,
the trio won.
Triple H was not a part of that match. And I got to agree with Mr. McMahon for berating Earl Hebner, Lillian Garcia, and JR this past Thursday on SmackDown.
Well, you could say that all three were caught up in the emotion of the moment, but Mr. McMahon certainly put all three in their place Thursday on SmackDown. Off the vertical suplex, another cover attempt and another near fall. But as you said, Michael, when SmackDown went off the air, it was The Rock making the defining statement. With Mr. McMahon flat on his back on the stage, the steel chair having been applied to the skull of the WWF chairman.
Well, you know, The Rock did make a physical defining statement, but I'd like to go back to the verbal defining statement that Mr. McMahon made, that he guaranteed The Rock would never be WWF champion again.
And we know that Mr. McMahon and guarantees are synonymous. Essa Rios now inviting Funaki into the corner. I've got to question the wisdom of that decision by Funaki.
Oh!
Tremendous maneuver, somersault. Wait a minute now. Face first to the back goes Funaki.
Uh-oh, looks like soup for dinner tonight. Hey, Lita.
How does Essa Rios come up with these maneuvers? And now to the top. The most beautiful
I'll take three of those to go.
Big win for Essa.
Big win for Essa, and it's always good to look at Lita.
Rojas Grande indeed. What a way to kick off heat. Once again, we welcome to the broadcast. And Michael, it's hard to imagine that we are just 7 days removed from what will be the greatest WrestleMania of all time, and certainly the greatest WrestleMania main event.
Well, Kevin, look at it this way. Stephanie McMahon Helmsley is now back in Daddy's good graces, and I don't see any way anyone will now get the WWF Championship from Triple H. But on